If you're one of the people wondering if you should give Chaos Vantage a try, maybe the recent updates will help you make up your mind. Let's see if it's really worth the hype. I'm not even exaggerating when I say that my mind was blown when I was trying it out. If you've never heard about Vantage before, it's a real-time ray-traced renderer that you use along with V-Ray. It's quick, easy to use, no optimization for your materials or geometry, just huge, fat-ass, high-poly, heavy scenes with high-res textures plopped right in there, and you can view it all in real-time with awesome quality and speed. Vantage uses physically-based lights and materials and global illumination for genuinely great results. This is an awesome tool, not just for ArcVis, but for PreVis, and checking out your animations with all the materials and lighting and stuff, seeing how it all interacts and works together. It's like a PlayBlast, but infinitely better. And if you are using it for ArcVis, it's really cool that you can use deforming meshes like AXYZ 4D or Anima 4D assets, so you can import animated people or like plants, you know, trees blowing in the wind or whatever, to make your scenes feel fuller, richer, and more realistic. By the way, if you've never heard of Chaos Partners in Art, listen up. It's a grant that you can apply for, and if you're an indie artist, content creator, small studio, or student who could benefit from their financial help, expertise, technical support, and exposure on their social media channels, then they're calling for you to apply. The link will be in the description of this video. Also, thank you to Moderna Media and Entertainment for sponsoring this video. But back to Vantage now. A great update that has been hotly anticipated is the V-Ray displacement. Yes, it's not just bump mapping, it's actual displacement. As you can see, it's legit, and it's finally here. It works with rasterized textures as well as procedural maps. Great for architectural and VFX visualizations. It also supports V-Ray Fur, Ornatrix, Hair Farm, and X-Gen, which can add some more sick detail and texture to your renders, and you can use V-Ray Hair Next material. So you'll only be having good hair days from now on. At least, in your 3D scenes. And another update is that it now supports the Intel Meteor Lake I GPU. So if you've never used Vantage before, or you're interested but you want to see what it does before dropping a bunch of cash on it, I'm going to give you an overview. What I thought was really dope is that you can use it as a viewport companion with Livelink, or as a standalone with an export of the scene as a VR scene file exported from V-Ray. With Livelink and the viewport companion, let me just open it up here, you can work on your scene with it open, and the changes you make will update live right here. So you don't have to do lame preview renders and stuff, and you also don't have to worry about exporting and importing files, which is really awesome for quick changes. Like when you have your supervisor or, God forbid, client breathing over your shoulder telling you to make changes, you can do it and see the results immediately. You can just navigate around the scene as you would in any 3D scene, and you see it updates really quick. So you can change your camera settings. You've got your camera lister here. You can add new cameras or views and see them in this window, as well as group them into folders to keep them nice and neat. And here we've got a tab for color corrections where you can adjust the exposure, filmic tone map, you can apply LUTs here, adjust the bloom, and obviously the standard hue and saturation, color balance, and even chromatic aberration that you can apply. You can try out new adjustments and settings and then save it as a new scene substate. So if you make changes to your scene, you want to try a different vibe, and you need to save the different versions to show your supervisor or client or whatever, you can save substates for light setups, materials, object transformation, and post-process for different cameras. Very convenient. Then we've got our render settings. You can use basic or advanced, and there are a whole bunch of options here too. Your noise threshold, lighting, global illumination settings. In the materials tab, you can toggle your reflections and coat and refractions and adjust the bounces, or, you know, if you want to get even more control, you can use the advanced tab, which gives you even more options. Moving over to this side, we've got environment settings, and again, you can apply and save your changes as different substates. You've got your settings for the sky over here, where you can use a texture or a solid color or a physical sky. You can also have a volumetric fog. You've got two layers of simple fogs for some nice atmosphere and depth in your scene. It's easily adjustable with the height, distance, thickness, and opacity. And there's a scattering fog, which also has a bunch of other settings if you want to have like god rays and stuff. And then you've got your ambient settings. You can change your ambient light color for warmer or cooler vibes, the light intensity and ambient occlusion, of course. And then your background settings, pretty straightforward. So in this materials tab, again, you can save different substates for different material settings, and you can also use clay mode and turn off and on whether you want to use the bump map or see the reflections or refractions or whatever. And then over here, we've got the scene states. This is where you can select which substates you want to use for the whole scene, because you can save different substates for each of the settings for environment, materials, and post. And here you can pick which you want to use as a combination together to make the entire scene state. And you've got your scene state listed here where you can have your different scene states. When you're ready to do a render, you head over here for more settings, or you can take a quick snapshot as well with this button. I like that you can set up your different render elements here. It's even got object and material masks, so you can use this for rendering your different layers for compositing in other software. In the camera type over here, just a mention which I think is pretty cool, you can render as spherical or cube for VR, and you can also queue your camera views and animation sequences for batch rendering. The standalone is even more versatile than using Live Link. You just export it as a VR scene file and open it up in Vantage, and you've got all these extra options for editing and tweaking your scene. You've got the Chaos Cosmos browser, where you can import assets from Chaos Cosmos really easily and quickly. So let's say I want to change these tables next to the bed. I'm just quickly going to turn off the motion blur and depth of field here. I don't need it right now. And I'll turn off the visibility of the old ones in the outliner. Find a model. You can click on the import button or just drag and drop it, and then move it to where you want it. If you right-click on the gizmo button in the toolbar, you can put in the values as well, so it's placed exactly how and where you want it. Really easy to use. You can use Chaos Scatter as well. I want this whole area to be grass. So I'll create a Chaos Scatter object, then I'll go over here, pick the ground area I want it distributed on, pick the object I want to instance, which is the grass here, and then we can play around with the settings to get it to look the way we want it. Oh, while we're outside, I can also show you that along with all these sun settings, you can have procedural clouds, and they're affecting the light as well. You can change the wind direction and intensity for if you're doing an animation. It's very cool. And as you can see, ridiculously easy to work with. If we navigate inside here to where this rug is, I want to make this a fluffy rug. So I create a new fur object with this button up here, and under the objects tab at the bottom here, I pick the source object, which is the rug, and it generates fur on the rug, and we've got some settings to play around with again to get the result we want. It's pretty intuitive, you know, length, thickness, gravity, self-explanatory. So back up here, there are a couple of other useful settings you can change, like here with the camera. You can toggle auto exposure on and off and adjust settings there. You can also pick a focus point, and you also have this grid overlay. That's very handy for getting a nice composition with the rule of thirds. Here you can adjust the navigation. Free look, you can just look around with your mouse like this. With this one, you can choose what to navigate around, like a central point. With this, you can increase the mouse precision, so for like those fine movements you might need to make. And you can adjust the move speed to get around a bit quicker if you want. And here we have some render settings we can toggle on and off and adjust. They're all pretty self-explanatory. It's also easy to make a camera animation here. For example, let's just do a simple pan. So I'll make a camera here with this view, save the camera, and then just using the right mouse button, I'll pan it to the side. And I'm going to press X here to level the camera and then save this camera too. Let me go back to the one I made before this and just press X to level that one too. And then I'll use this button here just to update it. Then I open up the animation editor and I'll drag the two camera views I saved over onto the timeline, and it'll automatically make an animation between the two. This is a bit fast for me, so I'll right-click here on the camera timeline and I can change the duration there. And you see you can also change the frame rate, and these are for the easing. I'll come back to those in a second, but right now I'll set it to 5 seconds, then play. That's better. Okay, let's take a look at the easing. Right-click again and all these options here are for the type of easing you can use, and if I change this to out quad, you can see it eases much more smoothly into that dock. You can change the view of the timeline over here if this way, time-based, isn't doing it for you. You can change it to a shot-based view, so you can more easily see the shots you've got in there. But you'll see if I play it, it doesn't play over the shot in a way that correlates with the time. But this view is nice as well because it's easier to see what shots you're working with, and it's easy to just add other cameras if you want to transition between those as well. So as you can see, Vantage has a lot to offer and a lot of capabilities. It's definitely something to seriously consider if you're looking for a real-time ray traced renderer. For me, the fact that it supports displacement and deforming meshes puts it above some other options that you have out there. It's really great for scene exploration and presenting to either colleagues or supervisors or clients. It's awesome for interactive look developments and obviously speeds up your workflow a whole lot. Hit the like button if you liked the video, subscribe to keep up to date with my other videos, and see you next time. Bye!